Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back again to the Skeeter Rabbit Road to the Show series here in MLB 15, the show on the PS4. You guys absolutely crushed it again in the last episode. Over 1,200, yes, 1,200 likes at the time that I'm recording this commentary. Holy smokes, guys. You guys are awesome. Let's keep it going for Skeeter Rabbit. Hit that like button and let's get ready to play some more AA baseball. Hopefully we can say AAA baseball soon, because we want to get this guy promoted and get him back to where he was before we lost his game save. So now we've got a 4-game set coming up against the Altoona curve, and we are going to play right through that here in this episode. So let's get to game one and get it going. But first, we see the AA stats to this point. Just 49 at-bats, but look at that, 26 hits and 49 at-bats. Yes, he's hitting over a .500 clip in AA. The competition is no match for him right here, and that's what we want to see. Build him up quick, get him on through, and get him on the fast track to the majors, to the bigs. Well, hits like this are going to help. Center field and down for a hit, and so now he can work his magic on the base paths. Let's see if he can steal second right here. Oh, you know he's taken off, and how many times have they gotten him? But they put this in play. That ball's hit down the right field line. Look at Skeeter go from first to home in like record time here. That's crazy how fast he gets around the bases. Oh, that worked out well. He just flew around on that double. Man, oh man, we need to take another look at this. Ball hit into the corner, and yeah, by the time they field this, Skeeter's pretty much touching home plate. Crazy fast speed for Mr. Rabbit. There you go. He's touching the home plate, and he doesn't even stop going to the dugout full speed. So it's 5-0 Erie right now. That's a nice snag by the third baseman. They will get him out in this at bat. Let's check in on the next one. 7-4. Pitch to Skeeter, the 1-2 count. Oh, he rips this one right center field. It's got some carry. Getting into that gap. It will one hop over the wall and into the bullpen. That's really unfortunate, because Skeeter would at least had a triple right there. But instead, he's forced to stay at second. Let's watch this again. Quite a blast to the gap. Couldn't quite get it over the fence for the home run. And then the worst of all possible things, it hops over the fence and gets him a ground rule double. When you're talking to the guy at this speed, it's not good. Well, he's going to take third either way. He says, that's the triple I wanted. I'm going to just go ahead and steal this base and get there one way or another. So now up 7-4 still at this point. This ball is blasted to right field and gone. Make it 9-4 with the 2-run homer. There you go. Alex Brisebois goes deep. I believe this was his second home run of the game. He was raking it in this one. Yeah, there you go. Clears the fence into the bullpen. And Erie is cruising. It's 9-5 right now. Skeeter steps up, slaps that one to right field. Hit so hard that they will have to hold that runner at third base. Base is loaded now, but Skeeter is on yet again. The only bad news, he can't really steal a base right here from this position since the bases are loaded. But let's watch the replay of his swing, hitting that over the first baseman's head. And yet another hit. So he has a 3-hit game, scores 2 runs, has that double in 5 at-bats. And the Seawolves win 9-5. All is good in Skeeter Rabbit Land, also known as Erie, Pennsylvania. So we continue on in this series. So far, so good for the Seawolves. 31-24 record now. And entering this game, Skeeter is red hot. He's got runners at first and second. Oh, speaking of red hot, look at that swing. Deep and gone. I think that's the longest of his homers so far. I believe that's number 4 on the season now. We saw 3 big flies in the last episode. But how about this one? 3-run jack. Gets him 68 points with that 2-time multiplier. And we've got to see this again. Only 389. I think he got cheated on the distance here, because this hits the top of that little shelter out in the bullpen. Man, oh man, look at this. Bam, right off the roof. It's got to be more than 389 to a shot out there. Anyway, they're down 4-3 in the fifth. That pitch is a base hit. There you go. First baseman was diving. Couldn't make the play. Throw to the plate. Oh, was in time, but offline. Runner scores, and Skeeter has struck again. RBI single gets him 30 more points. Altuna wants to just maybe forget about pitching to this guy in this series anymore. You got to look him back to first base. I'd be doing that 7-8 times until he just says, I'm not going to run. It's not worth it. But they only check over once, and now it's going to be off to the races when he looks that leg to throw home. And he's got it easily. Really, really hard to throw him out on the base pass here. He basically takes what he wants. He's going to third on this one, and he's there again. Good jump and a stolen base. Another 20 points. Easy way for Skeeter to rack up those experience points by stealing bases. Just got to hope he doesn't get hurt because, I'm not even going to mention that. His injury-prone ways. But knock on wood, things have been good since his initial injury this time around. So he gets another base hit right there. They lose 8-4 in this game. Skeeter Rabbit does collect three hits, including the three-run homer for RBI. Hey, Skeeter drove in all of his team's runs in this 8-4 loss. Somebody else contribute, please. Okay, so we got one more game in this series. Obviously, there's going to be a little spotlight look on that 4-RBI game. It's one of those things that always triggers a prospect spotlight. Skeeter Rabbit is red hot. Is there any doubt about that? Three-run homer this last time out. Let's see how he follows that up in the finale of this four-game set. Well, he hits that one right up the middle. Pitcher cannot get a glove on it. Base hit. Runner coming to score. It's going to be another RBI single for Skeeter. Starts this one off right. As, again, he has struck, starting to pile up those RBI in the last few days. 5-2 right now in the fifth inning. 1-1 count. Looks like this pitch is going to be up and in. Well, he turns around on that and hits it to center. Oh, he missed it. Oh, Skeeter sees this. He's off to the races. That ball's rolling towards the warning track. He's around second. Coming around third. He's not stopping. No way. Inside the park home run. You knew he was going to try for it. It was going to take a perfect relay to get him. As soon as that ball got past the center fielder, it was on. And let's face it, it was over. Skeeter Rabbit is going to go for it every time in a situation like that. No stopping him as he comes around to score inside the park home run. That'll be his fifth homer of the season, but that's the first of the inside the park variety that we come to expect from a speedster like him. That is wisely going to be played on one hop by the left fielder. He doesn't want a repeat of what just happened in his last at bat, letting that get by him and rolling towards the fence. So it's 8-6 Altuna right now in the ninth. Man, our pitching just not getting it done. That's going to be a base hit to right. And once again, playing that on a hop instead of trying to dive. And wow, did shortstop trying to spike that ball into the ground or when it came back into the infield or what? That's not exactly what you want to do. We got another stolen base coming up. Yes, sir, he's in there. Just a good jump, not a great jump, but it's enough to get it done. He's over at third base now, first and third. This is a drop third strike. If they throw down, the game is over, and well, game is over. That's how it's going to end on a third strike and a throw to first. Altuna wins again. So I think they evened this series up two games apiece. I think that's how it is going to play out. Yep, two wins followed by two losses. Now we're going to take on the Trenton Thunder. But first, you see another reset of the stats here so far in AA. And another spotlight, this one for a four-hit game. Skeeter Rabbit continues to be in the public eye here, in the media's eye, for his efforts. And they've got to be noticing in Detroit what's going on here with their prospects. So taking on the Trenton Thunder road game here now in the first inning. And Skeeter's going to get that one past the second baseman and get himself on base. He's got a hit streak going here. I think that brings it up to 15 games, if I'm not mistaken. On first, you know what's happening here. He's taking off. Again, just a good jump, it looked like. Yep, good jump, but the throw was high and had no chance of getting him. So now he's taking off for third, and okay, we're going to see a rarity here. They actually caught him stealing, going to third base. Well, kudos to them to actually pulling that off. Skeeter's like, how did that happen? But like I said, it is a complete rarity, and look at this. Oh, it did not look like he swung, but they say, yeah, they ring Skeeter up. He's not too happy about it. Looked like he held back there, but does not get the benefit of the doubt. 2-1 Trenton in the seventh inning. That one's going to be grounded to first. And runner coming home will score on the ground out, so it is an RBI for Skeeter. even though he was retired by the first baseman on the play. Doesn't really matter, though. Trenton wins this game 4-2, and that is going to be where we leave off in this episode. Yep, there's what I was saying. 15-game hitting streak. The big club has to be paying attention at this point, and you would think the call-up to AAA has got to be right around the corner. Probably if I simmed a few more games. The only reason I'm not simming games right now, and I totally would be, but I'm using that two-time multiplier, and I don't want to waste it. So when that's over, the simming will begin. We'll see you next time for more Skeeter Rabbit. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!